So this is the second chapter, and in this chapter we are going to start a new exercise, and this exercise we will make in the grammar. So basically we have some components for the grammar, and I want to show the concept that we will make. So this is the concept that we will make. We have this will be the handle, and the mechanical movement all the mechanical movement appears here, and we will define it in the CAD file, and we have some helper maybe supports here, and all this includes and connected to the shaft or the connected cylinder, which will be here. So let's get started by making first this item object, which is here. So we will start from the reference, and we will start from a line. This line start from 0 and 0, and we will work with the millimeter. So I will draw a line of length will be 100 and 0, and after that I will click escape. So we draw our first line, which is here, and it's already red because we are in the reference layer, which is red. And after that I will offset this line by distance of 25, and point is here, and another distance to be go here. And we can also draw a line and offset of 25, point on side of offset to be here. And again we will try to make a line starting from here, and I want to make it to be an angle of 35, and the line will be 70, and again going from here to be maybe here. Alright, so I will trim this one. I will select all these lines, and I will erase this and make line from 0 to this one. Then I will select all these lines and mirror from 0 and 0 to also to be here. I think we don't need it anymore, and let's go back and try to make some offset. Alright, then I will go to the object and draw a polyline. We can actually make a circle. So the circle will be in this area, and I want the circle to be around so I will draw the circle here, and then we can move from this point. So I'll draw a circle, and this circle here, and the radius will be 2 millimeter, and it will be 4. Let's move it from here to distance of And after that we will move from here and after that I will scale it so mirroring around this axis which is here. We have these two and we have also another circle here, so I will copy and copy from here to this distance. I think it will be here. Then I will mirror from here to be here. So already we have the circles, and these circles are closer to the distance, so I will move around 5 millimeter or 6 millimeter in this axis. So we will type 6 and angle of 0 to be here. Alright, and now we are done. So let's go to the object and go to the 3D modeling space and make sure to save your file now. Let's because we have now in the 3D modeling working space, we will start to define the shape. So starting from here to define our shape, and already we have defined all these points. And after that, I will go here, and we can select our shape, or let's go to hide the reference for now. So select our shape and extrude. After extrusion, we will extrude 5. And again, we will select some areas. We are in the top, and I will select this line and offset by 18. And draw a polyline from here to here. So we can select this line, which is this line, and so we have made the left side. Let's see what we have, and I will copy these lines already, and I will move from this distance to an horizontal distance like this, and I will select this object and copy from this point to this point. And after that, I will rotate, 3D rotate, which is here. Select the base point, I will select the midpoint from here. And select this axis to specify an angle, which is here. Then I will move from select this object and base point from here to be this point. And after that, I think we are now done. Let's combine these two. I will select these two and combine using this one, which is union. Select object and select object, and we are now done. Basically, we have some options here. We have these lines, and we want to close this area. So I will go to the wireframe and select this and this one also, and move from this one to be the perpendicular, which is here. Alright, and after that I will go to the conceptual again, and already we have some line here. I will go to push this area to be up to this area, and we have already some geometry here. I will union and I think now we have one object. We can already hide this object, go to the reference, select the reference and hide the object, and these are the reference that you have. Basically, you are now done for the first part. I want to make something finally for this object. I want to make some hole here. So how we can done this? So I will go to the reference, and I want to make some lines from here to here and from here to here. And after that, I will say that we have a circle. This circle will be the intersection from here, and the diameter will be 1.1. This is the radius, and we don't want this. That I will say another circle because we are using millimeter. I will say that the center point will be the intersection, and we have a radius of 5, which is here. Then we can remove these lines. It's much easier to select the lines in the mode of wireframe. So after that, we want to push all this using the push all the way down to here, and now we have this hole. And if you want to make the same hole here, we can make the hole by selecting the hole, or I mean the circle, and move from the center all the way in the orso. Up to here, we want it to be perpendicular. So I will move from the center to be in orso, and so let's go to draw some lines and some lines here. And move this circle from the center to the center. I think now we don't need any of these lines. So I will go to the conceptual, and final step is to zoom in using the scroll mouse wheel, and we can push again this one to around distance of maybe 4, and now we are done for our first piece. So this is our design, our first piece. So we can make some fillet here to make this shape nice. So I will select the geometry and go for the fillet and select first object and enter. So it's much better to make some fillet like this. So it's very simple. You select from the modify the fillet, and after that we can select an object which is here. So we selecting the fillet, select the first object and the radius to be 20.4 and the edge which is here, and click and enter. We can make the same here. Select the modify and fill it. Select this, and again we will fill it from here. Select object and select the radius, and we must select this one and go to the fillet. And I think now we are done for our piece of geometry. So I will save the file and start to the next chapter.